A peek into the lives of celebrities beyond the spotlight. Get to know your favorite stars in a whole new light. I'm Bianca Gonzalez, and welcome to The B-Side. Today, we're taking a peek into the journey of a talented actress whose passion for singing is as intense as her memorable on-screen performances. And now she's taking her love for music to a whole new level as she dazzles her fans with her first ever theater project.
Sino po ba talaga yung tunay na si Lina? Yung mabait kong ina? O yung sinasabi nilang demonyo sa lupa?
Kaya nga ito na, may second chance na ako para i-prove ang sarili ko, para mabigyang justice ko ang boses ko at ang aking kakayanan sa pagkanta.
Joy! Joy ang pangalan ko. At yun ang kabaliktad ng nararamdaman ko pag nakikita ko yung pagmumukha mo.
Hey David yan. Naiwan ang asawa mo sa bahay ko.
At ano namang gagawin ng asawa ko sa bahay mo?
Bakit di mo sa kanya itanong?
Ikaw ang tinatanong.
Hey! Pangpukaw! Ba ng atensyon ang kailangan mo, Kelly? Nandito na ako. Ako lang to, Kelly. Ako lang to.
So let's welcome to the B-side, Sue Ramirez. Hello!
Hi, Ate B. Thank you for having me.
Hello! Welcome!
Sorry, I'm feeling under the weather.
Pero nandito pa rin.
Yeah,
thank you.
Thank you for having me.
Thank you for making time for us, Sue. And congratulations sa iyong theater debut.
Thank you. I'm so excited. I hope you guys can catch it. Let's talk about it today.
Yes, let us talk about it today. At syempre, magpo-focus tayo sa iyong B-side, which is how, I guess, music has played a huge part in your life. So, let's take a seat para ano, comfy tayo magchikahan.
Ayan.
We want to rewind, syempre, to the days that you started in the industry and the days na na-discover mo yung love mo for music.
Yes.
So, everyone knows you for your acting roles. But, tama ba, when you first auditioned for Star Magic, it was as a singer?
Opo, para maging singer talaga. For as long
grade
as
school?
I can remember, I've
like
been singing.
Kinder?
Like kinder. My family, we love doing karaoke. That's our bonding. Every time na may mga family gatherings, nagkakantahan talaga po kami. My dad loved singing. My mom loves singing. Singing doesn't love her so much. But sorry, me, I love you.
She's gonna hate naman niya
me
yun,
for
I'm
this.
Sure.
But it wasn't really, ang ganda ng boses mo, kaya dapat kumanta ka. It was really more, nag-enjoy tayo, kaya tayo kumakanta.
Na-happy ka.
Oo, na-happy ako talaga. I love music. I watched MTV, Mix, and Channel V all the time when I was a kid. I was really musically inclined growing up.
And then, in schools, kapag sumasali ka sa mga contest, would you say na mas maraming panalo, mas maraming talo?
Ilan lang naman yung mga contest na nasalihan ko. First place ako nung grade 4 ako.
Oh,
kinanta ko ang Memory ni Barbara Streisand.
Wow!
Oh, diba? Nung grade 2 ako, second place lang ako.
Hindi lang, may place pa rin.
Second placer ako. Lima lang naman kami, Ate B. sa isang grade, limang section. So, lima lang
one
kami
representative
contest,
each. Okay. So yung grade 2, anong ako, song nun?
Colors of the Wind. Na isa rin sa mga audition pieces ko nung nag-audition ako for Star Magic.
Colors of the Wind of Pocahontas?
Yes, Pocahontas.
Grabe.
So, yun yung mga kanta na kinakanta ko. Yun nga, nagko-contest. Pero it was very innocent because I was very young. And really, I wasn't so competitive. I was just doing it kasi ako lang yung marunong kumanta sa classroom natin.
Ikaw yung ally.
Sometimes ganun, di ba? Ikaw lang yung marunong kumanta sa classroom. Kaya ikaw na lang, sige na.
So it wasn't parang contest, like, contest ako
hindi ako competitive na tao, Ate B.
Yung sinabi mong repertoire ng songs mo, ibang-iba eh. Di ba? From Barbara Streisand to the Disney theme songs.
Yeah. Growing up, I listened to old songs also. Kasi, well, medyo malaki yung range ng songs na alam ko dahil kami magkakapatid, di ba kami, hiwa-hiwalay kami ng
iba-iba
ng generation. Tapos lahat ng mga songs na alam ng mga kapatid ko,
na-expose
nila sa akin, exposed ako sa lahat. So, mga basha, time and tide, mga ganyan. You know, di ba?
Exactly. I can't like believe people, you know basha.
Exactly. That's okay. The songs that we sing. I love that song. A lot. My mom loves ABBA and The Carpenters. Mm-hmm. My dad was born 1935, so he listened to Elvis. Wala akong specific na genre na yeah. I belong to.
Yeah.
Rap, hip-hop, pop, rock, mm-hmm. punk, lahat yeah. pinakinggan ko. As in, ang dami kong phases ng music.
Ganun so, kinanta mo din? Nag-rap ka din?
Oo, mahilig ako mag-rap.
What is your pambato rap?
Pambato rap was Upuan by Glock 9. I spent so much of my childhood memorizing that song. And I love it so much. It means, yeah. ang ganda, ang lalim-lalim yeah. ng kanta na yun.
Iba din talaga si Glock.
Ang galing, ang husay ni Glock. Ay, idol.
Ay, ang galing! I love that. Pero pwede bang konti ng rap part ng sure. Upuan?
Tao po, nandiyan po ba kayo sa loob ng malaking bahay at malawak na bakuran, mataas na paderpi na paligiran, at nakapilang mga mamahaling sasakyan, mga bantay na laging bulong ng bulong, wala namang kasal pero marami ang nakabaro, lumakas man ng ulan ay walang butas ang bubong, mga plato at kutsara na hindi kilala ang totoo. Kari na si puti na gatas na nasa kahon.
Grabe!
Anyway, yeah, I love you, Glock 9!
So as a singer with your family,
yeah.
nagko-contest-contest sa school, ikaw yung vina-volunteer.
And First Friday Mass. Ah. Ako yung nagre-responsorial psalm sa
na
First
singing?
Friday.
Oh. Ibig sabihin, hindi ka shy at all.
Sobrang shy ako, Ate B. Kasi so, yung nanay ko palagi akong pinapakanta kung saan-saan.
Ah.
Tapos siguro yun din yung naging malaking push. Actually, hanggang ngayon may stage fright ako talaga.
Really?
As in. And at 27 years old, ngayon ko lang na-realize na, oh my gosh, I really have to face my fears now.
Wait. Eh, hindi ako makapaniwalang shy ka before. Kasi, yun nga, kung nagko-contest ka, tapos nag-audition ka on your own at 13. Like, okay. Was it an open call, go-see?
Oh my gosh, it was an open call, go-see. I saw a commercial on TV. There were Star Magic auditions. Mm-hmm. They were holding auditions. April of 2010, I lined up at the audience entrance of ABS-CBN. I was pang 697 ako sa pila.
Yun yung sticker.
Yun yung sticker mo. 697.
You remember the number.
I remember it as in, hindi ko talaga makakalimutan yun. Kasi yun yung nakadikit sa akin
yes.
the whole day I was there.
Yes.
I was 13 years old. I was alone. So I really just wanted to try it out. But ngayon nga, looking back, parang wow, I was so brave pala as a 13-year-old going into an audition all by myself.
Yes.
Wala akong pera, wala akong cellphone nun nadala. My sister actually had to, nagpanggap siya na mag-o-audition siya para lang mapahiram niya sa akin yung cellphone niya. Tapos mabigyan niya ako ng 100 pesos for water
okay.
and waffle time.
Okay.
na yun ang available sa audience entrance that
correct.
Time. I got there very, very early. The doors weren't open yet kasi
okay.
I wanted to be early kasi ano, so wala pa, hindi pa ako pwedeng pumasok, so mm-hmm. I went to my lola's house. My lola just passed
yes,
away
I saw
and
that in
yeah
videos. I'm so
and she's
sorry
she's one of the most supportive people
ever
when
seen.
It comes to like me like auditioning and
yeah.
nung nagwo-workshops ako, lola ko talaga yung kasama ko. Mga 11 p.m. na, medyo malapit na ako sa pila and they were cutting people off.
Ah.
Medyo malapit na ako, so nakakakaba yung feeling na, oh my gosh, buong araw na ako nakapila dito. Are they gonna cut me off? Are they gonna send me home? So it would have been a very traumatic experience. But lucky ako, and may guardian angel siguro mm-hmm. talaga ako, mm-hmm. na overtime nagtatrabaho. Umabot ako sa cut.
Okay.
And my audition song was Angels Brought Me Here.
Pero yun yung audition song mo because was that a song you would always sing nung nagko-contest ka sa school? Ganyan,
no, it
hindi?
Wasn't. Actually, I thought about it. I wanted Take a Bow by Rihanna, pero
ay.
Parang hindi siya pang audition piece. So sabi ko, okay, Angels brought me here. Well, Angels did bring me
yes.
to ABS-CBN audience entrance. After that, they got... lagi ako nagpe-pray, sana ma-call back ako. So, aantayin mo yun, syempre, kung tatawagin ka nila mm-hmm. ulit. And nagnonovena pa kami ng mami ko sa baklaran pag Wednesday. Para... Tapos may mga times talaga, Ate
Bina. Wait, so ganun katagal yung process of finding out kung nakapag-back na.
Talaga. Kasi ilang weeks bago ka ma-call back ulit. Mm-hmm. Lagi kang on the edge na parang, oh my gosh, am I gonna get called back again? Or ligwak ganun na ba? So, umiiyak ako sa simbahan, please, please, sana po. Tapos minsan, paglabas ko talaga ng simbahan, meron akong text na may call back ako. Ang daming moments na nangyayari.
Na ganun yung timing.
Na ganun yung timing.
In fairness.
Ganun ka dapat katapang dati talaga pagtatanggap ka ng project. Kailangan matapang ka, oohan mo na agad.
Yung surprise!
Hindi mo pa alam ganun yung gagawin mo, pero kailangan ready ka.
When you found out na, yun nga, pasok ka or like you're in the roster of new talent. Syempre ang inaudition mo singing. Pero ang first na nakuha mong project, was it singing na or acting?
It was actually a teen variety show in 2010 called Shout Out.
So Shout Out was the first. I didn't realize.
Shout Out was the first.
Okay. But that was, I remember nga, that youth-oriented musical variety show. Did you have a live audience when you
did
that?
We did have a live audience.
So how was that? Kasi nga as a shy girl,
I think, Ate B, yun yung pinaka-first time na na-immerse ako acting in front of an audience. Kasi nagkaroon ng segments sa Shoutout na parang pinapa-arte na kami.
Hmm.
Tapos, I did the skit
kay
Kim and Gerald na movie. Chinota mo, best friend mo. Yun, ginawa namin yung skit. I did that skit with Paul Salas.
Mm-hmm.
We actually ended up, I think, winning that. Kasi may contest yun every week. So, that was the first time. Narealize ko na, marunong pala akong umarte.
And then the first acting job that you finally landed was 2011?
Yes, Mula sa Puso. Actually, it was Okatokat first. But naunang pinalabas po yung Mula sa Puso. Para Okatokat, medyo na-delay kami. Pero it ended up, I think, airing at the same time. So I was very, very lucky because one of the first directors I got to work with was Wendy Ramos, who directed Mula sa Puso. Di talaga ako tumigil magtrabaho. Literal na simula po nung nagsimula ako, I did not stop working until this day.
I remember in 2016, when you were part of Dolce Amore, the soap, you also got to play a character that sang.
Dolce Amore, Star Creatives were one of the first productions who trusted me enough to have me sing on a project. Sumali siya sa tawag ng tanghalan. Si Angel Ortola, na character ko sa sa Dolce Amore.
Bigatin agad. Tawag ng tanghalan
talaga. At yung mga pinakanta sa akin, mga crazy tandingan ng mga kanta. Sabi ko, nakakaloka. At ginawa namin yun, Ate B. Sobrang bilis lang. They called me at, I think, 10 p.m.
Okay.
And we had to shoot at like 3, 4 a.m. Huh? And I said yes. Ganun ka dapat katapang dati talaga pagtatanggap ka ng project. Kailangan matapang ka, oohan mo na agad.
Yung surprise!
Hindi mo pa alam yung gagawin mo, pero kailangan ready ka. Kumbaga, sa sarili mo, kung ano man yung ipagawa sa akin, kailangan magawa ko siya.
And it was around that time you also got to release the single.
Yes!
The title of the single is Ako Sa'yo. Yes.
Dahil ako
sa'yo. So, syempre, ibang-iba ang workstation ng artista versus singer. Ang artista, syempre, set, ganyan.
Yeah.
Ang singer, nasa parang recording booth, ganyan. So, finally, nung na-experience mo yon, yung original mong in-audition, naglagay ka ng ganong headset, tapos nandiyan yung mic, tapos may glass, nakikita mo yung mga tao, producer, ganon. What did that feel like?
Parang mas mahirap palang maging singer. Yun yung naisip ko talaga.
Kaysa artista?
Oo, kasi sobrang mas technical lang singing. And, Ate B, kumakanta lang ako talaga, hindi ako aral. As in, hindi ko alam kung tama ba yung airflow ko. Kumbaga may boses ako, pero hindi ako sure kung tama ba yung ginagawa. Ang hirap, paulit-ulit. Tapos, for some reason, iba yung tunog ng boses mo pag nasa recording. So, hindi mo alam kung ano nangyayari. Tama ba na hit ko ba yung note? So, it was a big adjustment. Tinulungan talaga nila ako doon sa first recording ko.
A lot of people who might be watching this conversation really know you more as an actress.
Yeah.
But if there's anything that I want anyone to search for on YouTube, it's your Wishbus performance of Your Love. Para ma-introduce kayo kay Sue as a singer. 91 million views as of...
Nakakaloka yun. Thank you po sa lahat ng
nanonood.
This
recording.
91 million
beautiful
views.
Beautiful rendition, by the way.
Thank you.
Of a classic.
That was very, very, so, very unexpected. I was actually there to promote my single. Mm. And yung Your Love, hindi yun yung single na pinopromote ko. Pero yun yung sobrang pinakinggan ng mga ta. Your Love because I was doing Dolce Amore that time.
Ah, yeah, that's right. Yes, it was part of the soundtrack. Mm-hmm.
Nakaka-overwhelm. Hindi ko in-expect at all. Mm-hmm. All na aabot at lalaki siya ng ganun. At to this day that people still watch it. And when I go to Korean restaurants or mga fast food restaurants, yung mga tao, pinapatugtog nila yung Your Love.
Hindi
ko alam
ba,
sorry. Minsan, yes, while I'm there.
Ah.
Tapos sinasadya nilang patugtog eh. Tapos minsan, hindi ko alam kung ano ma-feel ko. But sa una pa, you get weirded about, oh, what do I feel? How do I feel about this? But, You realize na parang, wow, these are people who really support me.
And finally, 2019, I think perfect timing because this is after, of course, right before the world closed down.
Oh my gosh.
Nakapag-first solo concert.
Nakapag-concert ako noong 2019. It was my birthday concert. It was so intimate. The people there were really the people that I loved. And the people who really supported me from the start until, yun nga, medyo... tumagal na rin ako sa industry. My fans were there. It was si Direk Frank, he thought about forming a concert for me. It was such a fun time. I was just really enjoying the whole thing. It was, grabe, kumakanta lang talaga ako buong gabi. And these were songs that I sang growing up. I did an Alanis Morissette medley, may Philippine OPM band medley. So these are songs that are close to my heart and songs that I really sang growing up. So, I was very confident to do it. And knowing na yung mga taong nandun, mga taong kilala ko talaga, at mga taong alam ko na mahal ako at sinusuportahan ako, it felt like a safe space.
Yeah. Aso! Aso! Aso!
Guys, stop overthinking. And huwag niyong pangunahan yung mga sarili niyo. Things will always work out for the best.
Yes.
If it's not for you, hindi yan mapupunta sa'yo. Kung para sa'yo, mapupunta sa'yo. So, chill ka lang.
As bagong sabak sa teatro, we'll ask you to show us like a few things that you do to prep before either rehearsals or a run. Ano ba usually ginagawa niyo?
Nag-vocalize kami. Mm-hmm. So we would be running around the room while singing kasi it builds our stamina also.
Ah.
So habang like we do an exercise, parang aso. So paikot-ikot kami, pataas ng pataas yung note. Tapos tumatakbo
kami. Vocalizing pero running.
Tumatakbo, yes.
So rubber shoes, ganun.
Yes, naka-rubber shoes kami. At leisure kami doon.
At
leisure.
As workout gear.
Yes, naka-ganun. But we do stretchings also. So we have our dancers with us all the time. So we really like stretch. Kasi physical activity talaga. Mm-hmm. Medyo mabigat sa teatro. Ang laki nung physical na energy na kinakain niya.
Yeah. Ano yung vocal, kala mo naman kakanta. Ano yung vocalization na sinasabi?
Aso.
Aso.
Galing mo, Ate V.
Fairness, pero jogging.
Yeah.
I can imagine nga.
Yeah.
As in, how many rounds? Madami. As in, pawis, ganun. Hindi naman.
At first, nung nag-workshops pa lang kami, medyo tinesting talaga kami nito kung anong makakayanan namin. As in, parang 1 hour na yata kaming dire-diretso na tumatakbo. At 2-minute break lang. Tapos,
endurance
takbo,
talaga.
Yun talaga yung binibuild din sa theater. Na, ang ganda nung approach nila kasi hindi mo nakahalata na yun yung intention.
Mm.
Pero yun yung ginagawa mo.
Yeah. Of course, Little Shop of
Horrors. Yes!
This era naman of Sue's career.
Another evolution.
Because this is your first ever foray into theater. Do you remember the first ever musical you saw?
Bukod po sa Ibong Adarna na pinanood ko nung first year high school ako. Hindi. Na-immerse na lang ulit ako sa theater. Ito, medyo funny story. I went to New York with my best friend.
Mm-hmm.
I think 2 years ago. That was the first theater play that I watched.
Which one did you watch?
Book of Mormon.
It's Book of Mormon!
It's so good! It's
amazing!
It's
so wrong!
It's
like, manunod ka, God,
it's
sorry,
so wrong.
Ganon!
Yes, yes. It's And that's when you realize...
Such a good first experience.
Theater will make you feel confused about how you feel. It's so awesome what theater can do talaga. And
wow!
Ang ganda, ganda. And of course, di ko na pinalampas yung Lion King. Kasi I really wanted to watch Lion King.
Wow! What an experience na yung first live stage experience mo is Broadway mismo. So when you're watching that, meron ka na bang parang visuals in your head na ikaw ang nasa stage or wala namang
Yeah, my best friend was telling me, Ana, kaya mo yan, no? Ana, kaya mo yan, no? So she was telling me...
Siya ang nagmamanifest for you.
Well, matagal ko na rin naman sinasabi na gusto ko talagang itry. Kaso ngayon nga, hindi ako comfortable sa singing ko, hindi ako confident sa singing ko. I wanted to get better, I wanted to take voice lessons na hindi naman ako nagkaroon ng time na gawin. Mm-hmm. So, hindi siya nawala sa utak ko ever, Ate B. Parang all my life, parang along the road, I knew I was going to do theater at some point.
Oh.
If a door opens for me. And luckily, a door did open for me.
Yeah, so how did that door open? Ano yung unang sign?
So I think Toph was looking for Star Magic artists who wanted to audition for a play. And Derek Lauren recommended me. Utang ko talaga to sa childhood self ko na mag-theater. So agad-agad, I said, yes, Ate, I wanna try. I wanna do it. I wanna... Audition lang naman, kung hindi ako makuha, di try ulit ako next time pag meron. Pero nag-audition ako, sinamahan ako nung partner ko sa Little Shop of Horrors, si Reb Atadera. I was so lucky na siya yung nandun din kasi he really helped me get through it. My knees were literally shaking. My hands were literally shaking. I was so nervous because I really wanted to do it. My audition, sila Toph were there. Ginaid nila ako, tiningnan nila kung ano yung range ng boses ko, kung kaya ko bang abutin yung pinakamataas na note ng play. Tapos naabot ko siya, TV. Oo, nung nag-audition ako.
So, in theater, when you audition, do you also know right away? Or may waiting period din ng kung pasok o hindi? Or parang after ng audition, yes! It's
parang
a yes for us.
After ng audition... Sinabi na nila sa akin na
gosh.
Ako na. Tapos ang alternate ko, guys ha, ang alternate ko lang naman dito sa play na to ay si Karyl Tatlong Hari.
Yes.
What an honor, Ate B. What an honor for me talaga. Naiyak talaga ako, parang hindi talaga ako makapaniwala.
Miss Universe, ganun.
Nanghahawak pa ng
kao.
Yeah, naiyak talaga ako on the car ride home. Parang
Shucks.
I really... did not expect that to happen that day. And si Ate April, my handler, she really pushed me. Parang gusto ko nang mag-back out eh. Kasi sobrang kabang-kaba na talaga ako. Parang, talaga, papasukin ko ba to? Baka ano ko, baka mukha kong tanga dito. Alam mo yun, ang dami mong iniisip. Talaga, napapraning na ako. Tapos, well, anyway, guys, stop overthinking. And wag niyong pangunahan yung mga sarili niyo. Kasi tinan niyo, you know, things will always work out for the best.
Yes.
If it's not for you, hindi yan mapupunta sa'yo. Kung para sa'yo, mapupunta sa'yo. So, chill ka lang. Lagi ko na kailangan i-remind yung sarili ko na chill lang ako.
Congratulations! You did
Thank
mention
you.
The other cast members of Little Shop of Horrors. You are playing Audrey opposite Reb Atadero.
Yes!
Na isang napakahusay talaga na
professional,
theater actor.
Professional. More than anything, I think it's the emotional and mental support that Reb gives me. Especially when we do our rehearsals.
Yeah.
I still have that imposter syndrome. I still have those self-doubts. Especially being in a room full of like talented theater actors.
Yun nga yung tatanong ko. Because of course, Reb, kilalang-kilala sa theater scene. Nyoy, who has done so many productions as well. Karyl, who is a theater royalty, kumbaga. How did that feel, yung first few days ng rehearsal na parang bati ka
I was like a fish out of water, literally.
Did you like the feeling or did you like... die deep inside.
It's my anxiety that always gets ahead of me. I treated it and I looked at it in a way na I'm so blessed. I can learn so much from the people around me. Just to sit there while they're doing their runs, I learn so much. Parang, oh, I can do this. I can do this also. Parang, when I watch Ate Kay, how she sings, oh my God, she's so good. Kuya Nyoy and Reb and OJ Mariano and Odie Garmora. Grabe mga theater royalties talaga. Like, respected people in theater are around me. And I can either stay aside and mope and not learn anything, or I can observe and absorb. So, in theater, it's more of collaborative kasi ang theater, right. Unlike like when you do TV, there are cameras that you have to be mindful of. Mm-hmm. So you can't really go where you want to go because you're going to be covering mm-hmm. someone's face. Okay. In theater, wala eh. Sa harap lang yung audience mo. So you're so free to do whatever you want. And that was kind of a shock for me. Kasi mm-hmm. I was so used to like getting, being told. Being told, okay, dito yan, may mga T-marks tayo because hindi natin pwedeng harangan yung co-actors natin sa eksena or may mga important na kailangang details. So, sobrang ibang-iba talaga yung experience.
Yeah.
I loved it. I loved it, actually. Wow, it's so refreshing. It's so refreshing na I'm doing the same thing. I'm acting. Mm-hmm. I'm doing what I love. But in a different approach.
Right,
in a different way.
Yeah.
Sa TV, maarte ka, binigyan ka ng script ngayong araw na to. Bukas, iba na ulit yung script mo. Mm. So, etong script na to, tapos ko na yung eksena na to, kakalimutan ko na to habang
forever,
buhay.
Yes.
Hindi ko na yan iisipin. Dahil may bukas, may iisipin na akong ibang script. Sa teatro, ate, baliktad.
Right.
Minemorize mo yung script ng ilang buwan, pero habang buhay mo siyang dala. Mm. Habang buhay ko nang memorize yung play na to. And it feels so good to like have something inside you that you know so well. That you know, alam mo yun, yung na nakita mo yung proseso kung paano mo pinerfect to. Well, hindi pa perfect, pero kung paano mo siya binuo.
Yeah.
Yung may oras ka.
You play Audrey and Karel also plays Audrey. Yeah. Like, iba din kayo ng take ng ano. And what, I guess, what has Karel shared with you also na naging helpful for you in building your version of Audrey? Kasi iba din yung kanya.
I think kami ni Ate Gay, we also see to it na hindi kami parehong-pareho ng approach to give variation also also to the show. Actually, magkaiba talaga kami ni Ate Gay ng approach. When, if you watch both shows, you'll see kung anong difference. Si Ate Gay has been, she's the sweetest, kindest, prettiest person ever. She's so nice. As in, busilak talaga yung puso. Tas, she's always willing to help whenever I have questions. And alam mo yung hindi rin siya nahihiyang magtanong sa akin if she has questions. Na means so much to me. Kasi parang really for Karel to ask me what to do or ano.
Yeah.
Parang, oh ate, you trust me enough to like get my opinion about it. So it's very collaborative. Everybody in theater works together. And yun nga, before we do our rehearsals or runs, we have something called boarding. So nagka-company call kami. And then nagme-meditate kami for a while. And then we share what we learned for the day. Like, so it's very, sobrang personal yung relationship. Sobrang intimate ng space. Sobrang, ipaparealize niya sa'yo na this is a safe space. You can move, you can talk, you can shout, you can sing, top of your lungs, you can make mistakes, pwede kang pumiyok, pwede kang madapa. And everybody here, each and every person in that room will help you talaga overcome it. And it's such a nice community talaga.
Yeah.
I'm so blessed.
Anong sinasabi sa'yo ni Directo or your co-actors?
Si To, parang may sinabi siya sa akin last run namin, nung last rehearsals namin. Sabi niya, Sue, stop the imposter syndrome. You belong here.
Oh.
And you deserve to be here as much as everybody that you're working with. So grabe yung tiwala talaga at saka yung assurance ng ng mga tao sa iyo na parang wow, grabe to be trusted this way. Parang I don't even trust myself that way. Pero parang gusto mo na rin pagkatiwalaan yung sarili mo kasi nagtitiwala sila sa.
Oh, girl, ito na 'yon.
Ito na 'yon.
Ito na talaga 'yon.
Suddenly see more. Standing beside me.
Audrey is the perfect first role for a play. Una, medyo, alam mo yun, parang medyo malapit siya sa puso mo kasi medyo nakaka-relate ka dun sa character. And hindi siya ganun ka bigat vocally, hindi siya ganun. Well, emotionally, of course, very heavy also because we're talking about like violence against women and these are topics that our play will be tackling. But to play, kasi plays make tragedies into like dark comedies, diba? That's, yun talaga yung mga theme ng mga playets. They call it theater of the absurd, diba? Parang ganun. So, it's really dark comedy. So, I think na, kasi ako, Ate B, I always felt na comedy is my strongest suit. As in, I've always felt that. Like, doing Oh My Dad. Mm-hmm. I was so comfortable doing that show. I had so much fun. So, ako lang, for myself, I really, and idol ko po si Uge. As in, sa lahat
Eugene
talaga.
Domingo.
Si si Miss Ogi po talaga yung grabe.
Brilliant.
I really, really, really look up to her. And if, yeah, inspiration sa industriya, siya talaga.
Amazing. She,
amazing, amazing. And she also does theater.
Yes. Yeah. Your first love is really singing. And ang feeling mo, strongest suit mo in acting naman is comedy. Which as a viewer, we wouldn't have thought. Kasi mas either drama pa action pa nga minsan, di ba? Parang, but it's comedy. And ito yung confluence nung sa tingin yung love mo tsaka yung strength mo. To those who might not know, because I heard about this earlier, that you're really giving this particular role your all. Kasi ito na, you're even doing voice lessons on the side to prepare for this role.
Yeah, I have been coached by our musical director, EJ Yatko. Brilliant, brilliant. Sobrang galing ng musical director namin. I was lucky enough to be taught by him. Siya po talaga yung nagturo sa akin kung paano kumanta. Doon ko nalaman na, OMG! All my life, I was singing the wrong way.
Really? Meaning, yun yung mga breathing na nga na sinasabi
mo? Yeah, yung mga breathing pala, inuubos ko. Hinga lang ako na isa, tapos tatapusin ko yung buong line na walang hinga in between. Mali pala, parang puhunan mo pala pag kumakanta ka talaga, hinga.
Yeah, si Crystal, si Ronette, at saka si Chiffon.
Gusto mo yung unang sabak ko sa pagbabasa, sa reading, tatlo ako agad.
Hi, Crystal. Hi, Ronette. Hi, Chiffon. Am I late? Did I miss it?
Sure are, and sure did. Oh.
This is something I was curious about. So right here, we have a copy of your actual script.
Yes,
at
OMG.
At nakakatawa kasi actual script siya with notes.
Kita mo yung notes.
Kita mo yung mga
and
homework.
They get crazy. They get really crazy. I did this with Tof.
Establish eye contact.
Truth.
Imagine picture. So, truth with 3 exclamation points. So precious ito.
Sobra,
I'm sure talagang keepsake to for you.
Yeah.
Ako curious ako kasi nga iba ang atake mo na Audrey on stage versus like how it would be for TV.
Yeah, for sure. Yes.
So, is it possible if we ask you parang to say one line na as Audrey on the theater
stage? Yeah.
But how would it
be on TV?
Actually,
I'm changing my voice for the play.
Oh, really?
So, this will be out. We're running this, so I think it's okay.
Yes. So, you'll do the theater version
first?
Yeah,
I'll do the theater
version. So, what is one line and if you say it, theater version?
Okay, so... Okay.
Hi, Crystal. Hi, Ronette. Hi, Chiffon. Am I late? Did I miss it?
I'm not transformed.
Nagta-transform talaga. Ay, nag-iiba yung boses.
Tumaas din yung pitch ng voice mo. If you had to deliver this for, let's say, a series or a film, how would that be?
Hi, Crystal. Hi, Ronette. Hi, Chiffon. Am I late? Did I miss it? Diba?
Ay, in fairness.
So, mas cartoony talaga siya. And it really, you have to bring out the... It has to stand out.
Yeah.
Kasi itong play namin, konti lang kami. I think 8 lang kami sa stage. Yeah. So, unlike other plays na ensemble, na dami-dami talaga, 8 actors lang to. So, you really have to make your mark.
Yeah. Parang yung batuhan.
Yeah.
Teka, sino ako?
Ikaw si Crystal at saka... Ay, ikaw si Ronette at saka si Chiffon.
Si Ronette, girl siya?
Oo.
Ay, girl din siya.
Girl silang tatlo. Tatlo ka.
Okay.
Si Crystal, si Ronette at saka si Chiffon.
Tara, gusto mo yung unang sabak ko sa pagbabasa. Sa reading, tatlo ako agad.
Hi, Crystal. Hi, Ronette. Hi, Chiffon. Am I late? Did I miss it?
Sure are, and sure did.
Oh, Seymour's first radio broadcast. I wanted to cheer him on. I tried to be on time, but...
Don't tell me. You got tied up.
No. Just handcuffed. A little.
Ay, di ba? Pwede na akong pabatuhan. Pag-rehearse. Ang saya.
Yeah, it's very fun. It's very fun.
I hear it in your voice how much you enjoy it. Sobra, di ba? Rinig na rinig. And with that, ang iyong precious notes,
thank you.
I will hand it over.
Thank you po.
Salamat. Palakpakan natin si Sue. Galing. Dumating yung point na 7 days a week nagtatrabaho, uuwi na lang para maligo. Pero did you ever think of, tutuloy ko pa ba to?
When I was hosting pa ASAP Chill Out, 7 days a week ako nagtatrabaho.
Grabe.
And I think lahat siguro tayo dumadaan dyan. As in, lahat po ng tao sa industriya dumaan po sa 7-day work weeks.
Tama naman.
At full days to, ah. Hindi to, ano, yung literal na uuwi ka lang para maligo. Yung umiiyak ka na sa banyo, ano ba itong ginagawa ko sa sarili? Ganun talaga. May mga ganong moments. Minsan kahit di ko nababasa yung script, umuoo na ako agad. As in, kumayod talaga ako ng gusto nung kabataan ko. Humayin talaga ako. As in, wala. Kasi wala naman akong ibang ginagawa sa life, kundi mag-taping, mag-photoshoot ng mga endorsement. So, yun na yung nakasanayan ko. Mm-hmm. Comfortable space naman siya sa akin. Yeah. So, syempre, dahil bata ka pa, feeling mo kaya mong gawin lahat. So,
yeah.
Kaya ko yan. Tutulog ko na lang. Isisingit ko na lang yung mga tulog ko sa mga lunch break, ganyan.
Mm-hmm.
So, it paid off. It really did pay off. Nag-iipon ka ng trabaho eh. Siyempre, hindi ka naman ganun katagal sa industriya. And to be offered something, to be entrusted with something, a role, a character, that's a big, big thing.
Yeah.
So, I didn't want to miss any opportunity.
Yeah.
So, I accepted everything. And then, like, a few years ago, that's when I realized na, wow, wala akong na-form na hobbies. Kasi nagtatrabaho lang pala ako all this time. Walang time mag-hobby. Siyempre, jujowa ka pa. Diba? Ano yung hobby? Uh-oh. Wala lang hobby.
Na-backseat yung hobby.
Uh-oh. So, wala ko na form na hobbies. Tapos, literal na hindi ko nakilala yung sarili ko. Ano bang paborito kong pagkain?
Yeah.
Ano bang mga gusto kong gawin? Ano bang mga TV shows na gusto kong panoorin? Wala. Yeah. Parang na-lost talaga ako. And until now, at 27, I'm still trying to, you know, try to get to know myself. The person that medyo pinabayaan ko nung nagtatrabaho lang ako. A huge chunk of my life, I could not remember. Kasi I felt like I was sleeping the whole time. Yun talaga yung everyday na talaga, iba-iba yung character na ginagawa ko.
Grabe.
So, yung self mo yung hindi mo nabuo. Kasi buo ka ng buo ng ibang tao. Parang ganun.
So, paano mo na, I mean, after those projects finished, paano mo na resolve
I yun? I cut my hair.
That's why,
if you noticed, I always change the way I look.
Mm.
It's somehow, medyo, that's how I pagpag the characters.
Yeah.
And, like, prepare for a new character.
Like,
also.
Literally, physical transformation. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Para, ano na, a whole new you.
Yeah.
Because you mentioned it, gusto ko lang i-touch ng konti. Dahil nga, super busy ka, pero syempre, imbis na hobby, time for jowa. So, ibig sabihin, kailangan talaga naiintindihan ni jowa.
Yes.
That your career is priority.
Yes, oo naman ate. And dapat naiintindihan mo rin na yun din yung sitwasyon para sa kanya. Kasi mahirap naman yun kung one-sided na iniintindi ka ng iniintindi. Tapos you just want him to be there all the time.
Yeah.
Pero ikaw naman, hindi mo naiintindihan na may mga ginagawa din yung tao, di ba? Individuality, sobrang important.
Yung
meron kang ginagawa for yourself, meron siyang ginagawa for himself, and may ginagawa kayo together.
Yes. One thing also I wanted to ask you about, because I see it right here.
Yeah.
Here
tattoo.
You have a rainbow flag.
You have an eye tattoo.
So yes.
Kasi, I have a lot of tattoos.
I would like to think na now, less and less tabu na ang pagkakaroon ng mga tattoo.
Yeah.
But right now, ilan ang iyong tattoo?
I think 7.
Already?
Pito.
How long ago was your first tattoo?
What yung first tattoo ko po yung kilay ko.
Ay, counted pala yun.
So 1, 2, na-joke lang. Hindi. My first tattoo, it was a small heart here.
No,
it was actually heart before.
Pinatakpan mo.
Ang dami kasing nag-heart. So pinatakpan.
Okay. So the first one was a heart.
It's a heart. Small
what year
lang.
Was that? Tagal
I was
na?
20 siguro. 19 or 20 years old.
Tagal
na.
Okay.
Tagal na. Tapos sobrang ano lang talaga. Sa bahay lang. Yung houseboy lang namin yung gumawa. Oh my God.
Sue has
like
a flower here.
A sunflower
here. And then the words here are?
This is my código, Ate B. I did a mall show for a clothing brand.
Nakakaloka yung mall show código tas tattoo na ngayon. Totoo ba to?
Sa Mega Mall.
Okay, so bakit naging tattoo yung código?
Sobrang special pala niya sa akin. Doon ko lang na-realize nung araw na yun. Ni-request nung clothing brand na yun yung song na kantahin ko. I had to write down keywords of every verse that will help me remember the lyrics.
Right.
So, I picked up 4 words. This is a song by Keiko Necesario. It's entitled While We Are Young. And it's the official soundtrack of one of the movies that I did.
Yeah.
Ang Babaeng Allergic sa Wi-Fi. It says dance, try, Sail and Rise.
That is amazing na dinoodle mo lang siya in a mall show and then meron kang parang awakening na may deeper meaning
kaya
siya sa life ko.
Kaya ang pangit pa nung handwriting ko kasi nasa gilid lang ako nung stage. Tapos, shucks, di ko memorize.
Okay, so here you have a big eye. I think it's your biggest tattoo.
This is my favorite tattoo.
Really? What is
because
the meaning of
that? Because my dad's eyes were blue. Oh. And I didn't get them. So I had them put on. And nilagay ko na lang sa akin. And it's also an evil eye. It protects me from, you know, bad intentions from other people. I have a lot of evil eyes. I love it.
My
rings are evil eyes.
And then here.
This is a tribute to the industry that I love. Because sa industriya po na ito, mga bakla po ang nagpalaki sa akin. Yun ang totoo. So you can consider me babaeng bakla talaga. Aww. I have a rainbow tattoo here. I've had this for a long time. And it's a tribute and to show people that I'm an ally to the community. Happy Pride!
Belated happy Pride. Here on the B-side, we got a question online.
Okay.
And we wanted to ask it to you. Back to your musical roots. This is from Carlos Fernandez.
Okay.
Babalikin natin yung ano... as a singer era ni Sue, sabi niya, masusundan pa ba yung second song mo na In Love, na In Love?
Sana! Opo naman, of course. Huwag tayo nagsasara ng pinto.
If ever, dun sa mga, dun sa possible next single out, do you want to be part of writing?
Sana! Actually, wala akong... Hindi ko alam. Hindi ko pa siguro na-discover. I don't wanna close doors. So, if ever someone would collaborate with me to write a song, I would definitely love to do that. Something naman na galing sa puso ko, di ba? Something na galing sa puso at isip at kaluluwa ko. Would be nice if I had, you know, the skill for it. Yeah. I need someone there to help me, definitely. But I would be happy if I would get to do that.
Yeah. In due time, maybe.
In due time.
Pag may sign na naman.
Why not?
Pag may pinto na naman. Ito naman from Joy. Sabi niya, Sue, on what do you spend on the most?
Food. Definitely, yes. I'm a foodie. I love food. I love feeding also my friends, my family. Like, bringing them to, like, the best food places.
Ikaw, food.
Yeah. Tumatanggap ako ng gifts, pero hindi ako nagsishopping. Hindi masyado. Like, from time to time, of course, Ate Bibi, we have to shop, diba? Medyo guilty pleasure din natin.
Pero food talaga. As in, yung mga tasting menu, ganyan. Yung
yan, gusto-gusto ko yan.
Oh. Before we wrap this conversation up, ako personally, ang dami kong natutunan about you in this one sit-down conversation. Pero, ano yung isang nagugulat ka pa rin na misconception ng mga tao about you? Either they tell you, they hear you, they post about it. Is there anything?
The biggest misconception, I think, is... I think partly because I have this tattoo, is that I'm lesbian or ano.
Oh, really?
Na-issue kami before ni Maris Racal. Mag-jowa kami ni Maris.
I remember.
Guys, I'm nothing against it. I'm an ally to the community. But hindi po. Ang girl po ako talaga. Hey, Mayor. Hindi, I wasn't offended or anything. But like... Just to answer the question, what's the weirdest, like, misconception about
me?
And some people to this day still think that I'm lesbian, but okay lang.
What do you think is the other side of Sue? Kasi a lot of people nga know you as an actress, now as a singer and theater actress. Ano isa pang hindi pa siguro alam ng mga tao?
Kung sino ako sa bahay, feeling ko... Hindi ako kasi, medyo madaldal lang po ako at mukha akong outgoing. Pero yung totoo at introvert talaga ako. When I'm at home, I am at home. I will stay at home. You will rarely see me out. I'm a homebody and I have 8 dogs, 3 cats, and I enjoy their company very much. Ano kasi ako as a mother... Feeling ko, yun yung approach ko like to my friends. I treat them like family. I like feeding them. Yeah, when I'm not doing anything, I'm just really at home relaxing. Yeah. I think may utang din ako sa younger self ko ng pahinga.
Yes.
So, binabawi ko talaga lahat ngayon.
Very good. Oh, that's the other side of Sue naman. See, ibang side na kilala na din, pero may other side
I think feeling nila party girl ako. Kasi sabi ko na nga ba, judge nyo. Kasi madalda lang po ako, pero introvert ako talaga, ate. Okay naman ako sa bahay. Actually, I love being at home.
Super, it's the best. Ano siya, yan nga daw ang tunay na luxury.
Yes.
Diba? Kapag ikaw ay nagtatrabaho.
Papipiliin ako kung saan ako pupunta sa buong mundo. Sa bahay ko.
I love that. Well, I love this era for you na meron kang mix ng rest.
Yeah.
Finally, for yourself and doing something entirely new but you super love. Congratulations.
Thank you, Ate.
Please invite everyone to grab their tickets for Little Shop of Horrors.
Hello, everyone. I am Sue Ramirez, and I am inviting you to watch my theater debut for The Little Shop of Horrors, of course, produced by The Sandbox Co. Starting on July 6th to 28th, weekend shows po ito. Yes.
Congratulations, and thank you so much, Sue. Maraming salamat. That is it for our show. Join us again next time as we discover a different side of your favorite celebrities. Catch you again next time only here on The B-Side.
I'm happy. I'm very, very happy to be talking about this with anyone. Actually, I'm so excited to be talking to anyone about theater now. The emotion is palaging ganito. Lagi akong excited na nagkukwento. And napansin ko yun through like the people that I've been talking to recently na whenever I'm talking about theater, I feel like my heart blows. 'Yung cute ni Ate V, she's so game. She really did the vocalization na tumatakbo na aso. We do that every day for our vocalizing. And it's so nice to be throwing lines. She's so game and like to show you guys kung ano bang mapapanood nila sa play namin.
Ako mahilig talaga ako manood ng teatro. Kaya to see, first time ko actually yun makakita ng actual script of a play. Tapos nakakatuwa to see the notes at the side. So, kakatuwa. Pero never ko gagawin talaga. Mag-interview na lang ako ng artista ng teatro. Alam mo, the moment na we asked to say a line as Audrey, nakakatuwa kasi talagang nagtatransform pala. Like, from normal, na halos isang oras kayo magkausap, biglang may transformation. Nakakatuwa. And you really see, like, I'm sure you heard it, na every time Sue would make kwento about the experience, parang may ibang fire, may ibang kilig talking about theater. So, yeah. I love it na share natin yun dito on the B-side.